Good evening, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome.
Yes.
Good evening.
That is the power of books, especially fiction, a genre that is limited only by our imagination. Lucky for us, some of us have limitless imagination. Even luckier for us, those people who spend their time, their career, writing books, writing stories, each with a world of its own. But it's a world full of magic, a world full of fantasy, a world full of mystery, each has a story to tell. A story full of colorful characters, a story full of intricate scene action and suspense, a story full of unpredictable numbers. I have been reading them ever since I was a kid. The moment I start reading a book, just like that, I was no longer in this world. I'm no longer here. The book took me away and brought me into their world. As a kid, that was the most fun I ever had. I had fun slaying dragons. I had fun casting spells. I had fun going on adventures. I had fun interacting with their world. As a kid, to me, it was all the fun with none of the consequences. As I grew older, I still continue to read, but the reason has changed. Those fictional words give me another reason to read. As we grow older, whether you're a kid or an adult, whether you stay at school or you're working, you can never escape the monotonous routine of daily life. We wake up, we eat, we go to school, we go to work, we go back home, we sleep. We repeat this cycle 7 days a week. Added that with the stress of deadlines, stress of responsibilities and expectations, and you can understand why I read fiction. Reading fiction gives me that privilege, the privilege to enjoy the world so I can escape mine. The privilege to walk away from all this monotony and all the stress that comes with it. However, escaping reality is not the only benefit of reading fiction books. As Toastmasters, we strive to improve our communication skills so that one day we can talk to each other or even to strangers with confidence, no stutter, no ahs and ohs. Now, the one way to achieve this, as I have seen before, is that to have a personal connection with the one you're talking to. If you don't realize this, you never start the way talking to family and friends. In fact, you never been nervous, you never been fear, you never been anxious before you talk to them. Compare that to the anxious or anxiety or nervousness that you have before you come to the stage. That is the importance of personal connection in your speech. So the advice I can give is to read fiction. Reading fictional books improve your social connection with the other person. A study made by psychologist Keith Oakley from the University of Toronto found out that fiction readers have better empathy than non-fiction readers. Means that they are more able to understand the feelings of others more than non-fiction readers themselves. This is further supported by a study made by social psychologist David Kidd, who made a different study and came to the same conclusion. Fiction readers have better empathy. As such, they have it easier to have a personal connection with the other person, and as a result, they have more confidence talking to them. No stutters, no pass and ums. And then, these studies also give a new sight to fictional books. As psychologist Raymond Mao once said, that readers tend to shift their ideology, their attitudes, to those of the book they read. It comes as no surprise that fiction has made a big impact on the real world. For example, there's Uncle Tom's Cabin. You might not have heard this, but it's written by Harriet Stowe, and it is a story about the hardships that has been endured by African Americans during slavery times in America. It was said to be one of the reasons why the American Civil War started, because it was able to convince a large number of Americans that slavery is a crime, is a bad thing. Another example is The Sentinels by Arthur C. Clarke. A story about artifacts discovered on the moon popularizes the idea of space exploration. Said to be one of the reasons why the moon landing of 1969 was possible, because it convinces the public to back up on the funding by the government on the moon landing projects. Put it simply, fictional books are advocates of ideologies, of the moral issue of right or wrong, because they are able to tell it to a larger audience. And so here is my suggestion. Read fiction. Read fiction so you can escape from this world, so you where there's all the fun with none of the consequences. Read fiction so you can understand the feeling of others better, so you can have a better communication skills. Read fiction so you can better understand the world behavior, so you can have a better ideology, better understanding of the world. Just because it's not real doesn't mean it's not great.